Hello guys, so continuing my Ask Ali series, I'm gonna leave the link on the form that you can fill in. If I choose your question, I might make a video about this. The next question is by Hannah. Thank you for your amazing videos. They are so inspiring. Thank you. My question is about not wanting to wear makeup. How can I focus on beauty and looking fresh and approachable without makeup? Thank you so much, Hannah, for your question. I am so much like you in this case. I don't like wearing makeup. On a daily basis, I don't wear makeup at all. I only wear makeup for the videos, for the parties, and for the stage, of course. But even on stage, sometimes I don't wear foundation. I just put some powder and I just do my lashes and I just go and sing right in my glasses. If it's acoustic gig or something, if it's like small stage or something like that. I just don't like wearing tons of makeup. But on the other hand, I love makeup very much, so if I have to go on stage, I do. But is it possible to look beautiful and fresh without wearing any makeup? I think yes, of course it's possible. For any woman, yes, I think for any woman. So the first tip, of course, is taking care of your skin, which of course everybody can tell you this because it's an obvious thing, right? So you're taking care of your skin. Skin is very important. It's one of those three the most important things if we talk about beauty. Not the makeup, not the clothes, not accessories. Skin. Just skin. So we're taking care of our skin, just doing special procedures and taking care of what we eat, how much we sleep, try not to overstress, and so on and so on. It's very, very important. Of course, if you have some small imperfections on your skin, you can always use sometimes some foundation or some concealer, trying to use something that is not very aggressive, maybe something with natural ingredients, maybe something that is slightly on a more expensive side, but at least you don't use it all the time or you're going out and you're using it. But just in general, if your skin doesn't have any pronounced redness or super dark circles under your eyes, I don't think that's needed. So even if it has some lines, wrinkles, it doesn't matter. Lines, wrinkles, it's wonderful. We just don't want your face to look dry, because when it looks dry, it looks very dull and your face is not shining. So in this case, yeah, we just use good products for our skin. Everybody uses their different skin products, so it would not look very dry and dull during the day. So it should reflect light and look moisturized. The next thing is a very important thing is haircut and hair color, both. They both are very important. If you have an amazing haircut, but your hair color just doesn't fit you, not gonna work. And on contrary, same thing. If it's amazing hair color for you, but the haircut is not for you, or you have super thin ends, for example, very thin hair and very thin and pretty and hair in pretty big bad condition, maybe that, I don't know, platinum blonde or black color suits you very well, but if your hair doesn't look healthy, then of course we can't talk about this, right? So we need to cut it more blunt. We cut the ends. We need fresh cut. It doesn't matter what length of your hair that is. If you have long hair or short hair, we need that more blunt cut. We don't thin our ends. And the more blunt cut there is, the more healthy it looks. And it starts shining more. Cut them yourself. Don't worry, in 10 days, approximately after 3-4 washes of your hair, sometimes it just lies down to a perfect shape, to a shape that you wanted. It doesn't create shape right after you cut it. So you would know. If you have right haircut and right hair color for you, especially if it's very well done, and sometimes some women, they don't need that all that complicated things, all those balayages and stuff. One good rich hair color. Some women have white and gray hair. They had enough patience to grow out their colored ends and just to have that beautiful platinum white silver hair. That's amazing looking. Normally looks very thick if it's combined with good haircut. So that already can create more uniform look for you. Number four, if you're going without makeup, sometimes it makes sense to make your brows slightly darker. What I do now, I just moved to the United States this year and I was trying to find a good brow dye in the shops and I couldn't find it. It's very funny because I went to like Sally Beauty Supply, special shops where they sell it. I couldn't find it because in Russia, it's everywhere. In every shop or cosmetic shop that you go, you can find several brands selling different brow dyes. I found in Walmart a dye for men's beard. I bought Actually, slightly darker than you would probably think. I like my brows slightly darker for the same reason, because I love going without makeup, and sometimes that darker color here on my brows, that gives me more weight, more heaviness for my face. My face is not super light. It's like I have pretty wide face and my bones, like, it's pretty strong. So having something darker and stronger on my face, so that helps me to frame my face and to give more visual weight, basically, to my face. And I dye my brows from time to time, and it lasts for very long. It's very cheap, and I love the result. The result is amazing. I want to warn you, if you buy same stuff, be ready to apply it very fast and wait for a couple of minutes to 5 minutes. It depends on how thick your brows are, how thick the hair on your brows are. My hair on the brows are thin, so I wait for a couple of minutes, and then when I wash it off, it stains your skin. So it looks like a tattoo. So first of all, make sure that you are applying it very carefully. And I normally apply it in the middle of my brow, and then I add a little bit in the front here, but not too much. Otherwise, it's just... But even if it stained your skin too much, don't worry. Like, you can scrub it a little bit, like do a little peeling here at the beginning of your brow. In a couple of days, it's gonna be fine. But yeah, first time when I used it, oh my god, you had to see my brows. It was very funny. So I just covered them a little bit with the foundation. Just have to warn you. But from the skin, it washes off in a couple of days. But then your hair stays very dark. And then our hair just falls out, new hair is growing, so it becomes lighter and lighter and lighter again. So I just do it again. Maybe in 1 month I'm gonna do it again, I don't know. That's another thing, how you can make it work for yourself. And you don't even need that microblading. You can do microblading too. I didn't do that because I just like this way much better, because it's under control. I know the color, I know what kind of the color I'm gonna have later and stuff like that. So I just love having my salon at home. So yeah, darker brows sometimes add some statement to the face, some finish. It's a finishing touch to your face. It can do actually wonders if it's well shaped and if it's slightly darker. Number 5, optional, not everybody likes accessories. You can do without them, but I find that this kind of earrings is the most universal and looks great. It's kind of freshens the look. It catches the light from time to time, whether it's underneath your hair or you're making an updo and you have it just on your ears. You know, that thickness and that size, it looks best on everyone. And even the silver, I think it looks great on everyone. Doesn't matter if you're warm skin tone or cool skin tone. I think that just very universal. It looks amazing. Number 6 is, again, optional. Not everybody likes that, but it's accessories. For example, I have bad eyesight, so I have glasses. So I'm wearing glasses most of the time. Sometimes I have contact lenses, but most of the time I'm in my glasses. So glasses can change a lot, especially if they have very certain shape, heavy shape, thicker shape. For example, if you have darker hair and lighter skin, for example, you can wear this. Or if you have dark skin, you can wear something beige or very fresh yellowish champagne color frames for your glasses. It can give so much finish for your look without any makeup too. And then different hair bands, for example, different scarves, something like that. It can also add something like a finishing look. You don't even need that makeup. All right, that's it. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know if that was helpful. Let me know if you're doing already some of those things and if you notice that you really don't need that makeup as much anymore. All right, guys, thank you, and I'll see you very soon. Bye-bye. Subscribe on my Pinterest for 13 boards as an inspiration for the body types. Also, you can subscribe on my Instagram. All the links I'm going to leave down below. Also, you can become my sponsor or subscribe on my Patreon for some exclusive videos, some early access to these videos, and just if you want to support me and my channel. Thank you so much, guys, and I'll see you very soon. Bye-bye.